In this chapter, we will be learning about powers and radicals. In this lesson, we will summarize the laws of exponents.
So, here in this lesson, we're going to look at the rules that govern how we use exponents. Now, some of these rules are going to be familiar to you. Some of them are going to be a little bit new. So, let's just take a quick look here. In fact, let's maybe zoom in a little bit here. So first of all, we're going to start with the multiplication law. If you've got two powers multiplied together and they have the same base, then you simply add the exponents together. Actually, that makes perfect sense here. Let's say we had x squared times x cubed. Well, let's think about what that is. That's x times x multiplied by x times x times x. Remember what the exponent does. The exponent tells you how many times that base there is a factor. Well, when you put those together, you've got five factors here, so that's x to the fifth. That's really just the sum of those two. Now, it's really important that you understand that this is how this works. This is how this always works, okay? Because there have been times when I've seen people that want to do this here, where you've got, let's say, 2 squared times 2 cubed. Let's kind of use the same pattern here. Now, at this point here, it should be clear that the answer here is 2 to the fifth. However, I've watched people do this and write, well, that's got to be 4 to the 5th because you multiply the bases together. And No, you don't. What you're doing here is you're multiplying the powers, the entire thing. Okay? You multiply the entire thing. And the way we do that is to leave the base the same and then to add the exponents. Okay? That's how you do that. Don't think of it as multiplying the bases together, because you're not. You're multiplying the powers together, and we do that by adding the exponents. Now, obviously, the division law, the next one here, is the opposite in terms of operation here. So when we've got two powers and we're dividing them, we simply subtract the exponents. Okay, and it's for a very, very similar reason. If you've got, let's say, x cubed over x squared, that is x multiplied by x multiplied by x over x multiplied by x. And then we can take the factors here and group them together in these little pairs here, because x divided by x is 1, x divided by x is 1. So because we had an xs on the top, that's all we're left with. So yeah, x cubed over x squared, oops, would simply be x to the 1 left over. And there we go. Next is the power law. If we've got, a power of a power. And then what we just simply do here is we multiply the exponents together. Now, this is a rule here that causes a lot of problems later on with the math that you're going to be doing here. Just to explain what's going on here, there's a couple things you need to know about this. So if you've got a power of a power here, you simply multiply the exponents together, okay? And again, it's easy enough to explain why that works. Let's go over here. Let's say you have, for example, x cubed squared. Well, what that square means is you've got x cubed multiplied by x cubed. Okay? And then we would just apply the rules here. If you would then add those two exponents together, you get x to the sixth. But just think about that. I have two threes here. Well, that's multiplication, right? When I'm adding the two threes, that's just 3 times 2. And that's why that rule works. Now, here's another aspect of it. If the part of the base here, if the base consists of multiple factors, then what happens is that exponent gets distributed to every factor in the base. But I have to say this again. It's if your base consists of factors, many factors. Okay, here's the problem that people are going to have later on here. Let's say that I've got x plus y to some value a, let's say. This does not equal x to the a plus y to the a. There's a very, very distinct difference between these two expressions. And the difference here is that this is a monomial in here. This is a binomial in here. These are multiplied together, so each of these here, the 2, the m, and the n, are all factors of that monomial. X and y are not factors here. These are what we would call addends. You cannot distribute that over. The rule is very different when you've got a binomial or larger as the base of that power here. Please do not confuse these two rules. Oh, please don't confuse them. Okay, this... people doing this right here causes the loss of so many potential marks in future exams. This problem right here. You can only distribute over factors. Okay. And then the same thing happens over here. If you've got a quotient here, you can distribute the power here to both the numerator and the denominator. That's the rule for that. Okay, now another one here. This one here you should be totally familiar with. X to the 0 is equal to 1. Now you might not understand why that occurs. Actually, the pattern is quite straightforward. I'll just give you an example here. Let's say you've got 2 cubed. You know that that's 8. 2 squared is 4. All I did was I subtracted 1 from the exponent, and then I took this value here and divided by 2. Let's do that again. So 2 to the 1 is 2. I subtracted 1 from the exponent and divided by 2 on the other side. And now I'm just going to follow this pattern. If I subtract 1 from the exponent, I get 2 to the 0. And if I divide by 2, I'm going to get 1. That has to be true. It has to be true. So it has to be the case that x to the 0 is equal to 1. Okay? Now, I know when people look at that, and they're like, shouldn't that be 0? But it's not x multiplied by 0, it's x to the exponent 0. Okay, so the rule is a little bit different. Please do not misinterpret that and see that as a multiplication. Now, here we go. Negative exponent laws. Okay, if we take this little pattern here, right here, one step further, the very next thing I would do here is to subtract 1 from that exponent. I would get 2 to the negative 1. And if I was to divide by 2 right here, I would get 1 over 2. So now notice what happens here. Notice that negative exponent is equal to a reciprocal. Okay, on the right-hand side here. It takes that base and reciprocates it. If I was to go one step further here, this would become 2 to the negative 2. And then what would happen is I would divide by 2 again, and this would become 1 over 4, or 1 over 2 squared, if you want to think of it like that. But notice what that negative in the exponent does. Okay, it moves this expression here that's really in the numerator, this is like 2 to the negative 2 over 1, and pushes it into the denominator, and then it becomes a positive exponent. Okay, that's what the negative exponent does. It doesn't change this thing into a negative value. Because you got to understand, this again, where people get confused by this is assuming that this is multiplication, but it's not multiplication, okay? It's a shorthand for referring to a bunch of multiplication, but this is not multiplication in and itself, okay? So this negative does not make this whole term negative. In fact, it causes a reciprocal. Or, likewise, if you've got 1 over b to the negative 1, again, that negative 1 there is going to cause a reciprocal. It's going to cause a thing to pop up. Okay. Now, finally here, we're going to take a look at fractional exponents. We've already spent a little bit of time looking at this. If you've got x to the 1 over m, okay, we already know that m becomes that root index, that this is the same as a radical. And if you've got x to the m over n, then it's the nth root of that power of x there, x to the m. Or that exponent there can happen either inside the radical or outside the radical. Either one of those is totally acceptable. They're equivalent to each other. You will find, though, that this is often the easiest to work with, I guess is the best to say it. They're both really the same, doing the same thing, but it's often easier to reduce the radical first and then apply the power than it is to do that in the other order.
The following are examples of the multiplication law.
Okay, so for this little section of questions here, we're just going to apply the exponent, the multiplication law here. So x cubed times x squared, we're simply going to add the exponents together, we'll get x to the fifth. 3 to the exponent a multiplied by 3 to the exponent b. Well, I don't know what a and b are. I don't know what they are, but I do know that this operation tells me to add the exponents, so I can't go any further than that. So I would simply say here that I have to add the exponents. That's what that's expressing. S to the fifth multiplied by s. I have to remember that if I've got a power sitting there and the exponent is not written, that implies that that's 1. So this would be s to the sixth when I add those together. And then over here, It doesn't really matter here that this is a negative exponent here. When I multiply these two powers together, I'm still going to just add the exponents together first. Okay, so 4, this is going to be, x to the 4 plus negative 2, which is just 4, x squared. Now, keep going here. This means the same thing. And I'm going to have 2 to the negative 2 multiplied by 2 cubed. Now, to start off with, again, I see this as multiplication, so I'm just going to multiply these together. So I'm going to add the exponents. And negative 2 plus 3 will be just 1, so this will be 2 to the 1. And I don't have to write the 1 if it is just 1. Here, 3 cubed multiplied by 3 to the negative 3, well, that's going to be 3 to the power of 3 plus negative 3. Now, that's just going to be 3 to the 0, and we've already seen that that is equivalent to 1. Okay, now here we go. When you multiply these things together, bear in mind that everything in here is being multiplied together. Like, even though we're writing this differently here, between the two parentheses here, that implies multiplication. The fact that these guys are all bunched up together, there's nothing written in between, implies multiplication. These are all multiplied together. Okay? I am free to multiply in whatever order I wish. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to rewrite this. This will be 2 multiplied by 3. Can I move the 3 up? Absolutely. Order doesn't matter with multiplication. Make that x multiplied by x to the negative 1. Can I do that? Yes, I can. Order doesn't matter with multiplication. Y squared, y to the 0. Can I do that? Yes, because once again, order doesn't matter with multiplication. I can write that in whatever order I wish. Now, I can multiply 2 times 3. That gets me 6. X multiplied by x to the negative 1 is going to be x to the 1 plus negative 1, and I know what's going to happen there. And then this is going to be y, 2 plus 0. Now, this is going to end up being 6, this will be x to the 0, and then 2 plus 0 is squared there. So I'm almost done here. I'll just go off to the side here. X to the 0 is just 1, and 1 times 6 multiplied by y squared is simply going to be 6 multiplied by y squared. So that's as simple as I can make that expression. Now, I hope what I did there makes sense. You should be able to get to this answer a little bit quicker than what I did there, but again, there tends to be a little bit of confusion with this because of the multiple variables together and how to treat that. But you're only going to, the only things that I can simplify here, even though they're all multiplied together, the only thing I can simplify here are the powers of the same bases or the coefficients. Okay, so I am multiplying 6 by y squared here, but I can't go any further than this because I don't know what y is, and so that's a dead end. Until I know what numeric value this takes on, I cannot multiply it by the 6. All I can do is state that it is being multiplied by the 6. That's it.
The following are examples of the division law.
All right, in this section of questions here, we're gonna apply the division law here. I have very similar to what we did with the previous set of questions here. Just in this case, we're going to do subtraction here when we're dealing with the exponents. So x to the 5th divided by x squared is going to be x to the 5 minus 2, which is going to be x cubed. Over here, 3 to the m divided by 3 to the n. Now, in this case, I don't know what the exponents are. So the best I can do is just identify that that's what I would have to do. That once I know what those numbers are, I would need to subtract them to complete this operation. Okay, over here, just another way of writing that, and you should be familiar with this. So this is going to be x. Now, x in the numerator, when I do it like this, to the 12 minus 3, and then 12 minus 3 is 9. Okay, but we consider this in the numerator. When I bring that up as a subtraction up here, I'm assuming that what I'm left with is going to be in the numerator here. Here, don't let the fact that the exponent in the denominator is negative, don't let that throw you off. It doesn't matter. Just move ahead the way you know you should. The division here means that I'm going to take the exponents and subtract them. It's just in this case I'm subtracting a negative. And so remember what you do when you subtract a negative. You're going to add that, and so you'll get x to the 6th there. Okay, same thing here. So this is going to become 5 to the exponent of 3 minus negative 4 for an overall result of 5 to the 7. Okay, now here, there's a little bit more going on. And so what we want to do is we want to deal with order of operations. Okay, we want to follow order of operations as strictly as we can here. The bar always implies a set of brackets around the numerator and the denominator. So the very first thing I want to do is simplify the numerator and simplify the denominator. Now, in this case, the numerator, there are no common bases there amongst those factors, so I'm done. But in the denominator, I've got a 2 multiplied by a 1, so it's going to be 2. M squared multiplied by m. Well, I'm going to add the exponents together, so that'll be 3, because remember, if it's not written, it's a 1. I've got n cubed multiplied by n squared, so I'm going to add the exponents, that'll become n to the fifth. And so now I'm left with I've still got this 1 half, I've still got this 2 in the denominator, so I'm just going to leave it like that. And then I'm going to have m to the fifth minus 3, so I'm going to subtract the exponents, you can't see that. And then I'll have n to the negative 1 minus 5. And so putting that together, I will end up with m squared n to the negative 6th over 2. And what I would do with this, and I'm running out of room down here, so I'm just going to go to the side here. What I would do with this typically, and it's not absolutely necessary, there really is nothing wrong with a negative in the exponent, okay? You are going to have, there will be lots of people that will tell you that it's better form to not have negative exponents. That's more of a personal preference thing. There's really no rule that says you have to do it like that. But you're going to see most people are going to take that and write it with a positive exponent by simply moving it to the other side of the fraction. So this will be m squared over 2, and then that n to the 6th simply moves into the denominator. And there you go. And now finally, in this case right here, it's very similar to the question that we just did. We're just going to deal with the pieces that can be put together. So for example, the 15 and the 20, there's a common factor of 5 there, which would leave me with 3 over 4. Now I can't do anything else with that. That's good. When I do the subtraction here, this will be m to the 7 minus 9 in the numerator. Oops. N to the negative 1 minus negative 8. Again, in the numerator when I do it like this. And so now this will be 3 quarters m to the negative 2. N, now negative 1 minus negative 8. Be careful with that. Okay, whoops. We already know that as soon as we start throwing negatives around, a lot of people are going to make mistakes here. So that should just be a clue to you that when you start to see these negatives showing up, that you really do need to be careful with the arithmetic here. Negative 1 minus negative 8 is going to be positive 7. And now, because there's going to be a bit of a push on you to write things with positive exponents, we're going to take that m to the negative 2, we're going to move it to the other side of the rational here. Whoops. And there we go. So 3n to the 7 over 4m squared.
The following are examples of the power law.
All right. In this section of questions, we're going to look at the power law. So we've got x cubed squared. I remember what that means. When you've got a power of a power, we're going to multiply the exponents together. So this will become 3 times 2, or x to the 6th. Okay. And don't forget how this works. As long as you've got factors here, as long as these are multiplied together, okay, that there's only one term in there, I can take that exponent and I can distribute it to the two factors here. So this will become m to the 5th. And this will become n to the, and then it's going to be a power of a power, so I'm going to multiply the exponents. This will become m to the 5th, nothing else to do there, n to the 20th. Here, same thing, because there's parentheses here, that 2 can distribute to the both factors here. So this will become 3 squared, and then this will be z to the 6 times 2. And the reason it just becomes 3 squared here is because the number that's the exponent on the 3 is a 1, and 2 times 1 is 2. We're just going to do that. Now, it makes more sense to write that as 9, and then this would be z to the 12th. Here, very similar thing, and it's just in this case that exponents will distribute to all of the things that are being either multiplied or divided together. Again, as long as there's no, that we're not dealing with binomials or larger in here, we're okay to distribute the exponent. You can't do it if there's a binomial or a larger polynomial in there. But in this case, we're fine. So this will become, Sorry, I don't know why I started writing a 5 there. This will become r to the 2 times 3. That will distribute to the 2 here, so 2 cubed. And then this will be t to the 5 times 3. And then we can simply do the a little bit of arithmetic that we're being told to do here. So r to the 6th, this will be 8 t to the 15.
Oops. Now, this question right here.
Now, in this case, order of operations is our guiding rule here. So the first thing we're going to do will be the brackets, what's inside the brackets, but there's really nothing to do here. So I'm going to do the exponent prior to doing the multiplication. So this will become b to the 2 times 3 times b to the 4 times 4. I'm going to do this first here. And this is going to get me b to the 6th multiplied by b to the 16. Okay, now I can move down and deal with the multiplication. Now that I've dealt with the exponents and the brackets here, now because the bases are the same, it will become b, and I will add those exponents together because that's what the rule is for multiplication. So my final answer here will be b to the 22. Here this is really no different than a couple of the previous ones we've done. Because everything is being multiplied together here, I can distribute that 2 to each of the exponents, so 3 squared, x to the 6 multiplied by 2, y to the 5 multiplied by 2. That's going to be 9, x to the 12th, y to the 10th. And there we go.
The following are examples of the zero law.
All right, we're just going to look at a few questions here that talk about the zero law here, what happens when zero's in the exponent. And this should be pretty straightforward, I'm hoping. There is, however, an opportunity for people to make mistakes here because they're simply not 100% clear on our notation. Notation is very, very important in mathematics. But here we go, 5 to the exponent 0, that is simply going to be 1. Negative 5 to the exponent 0. Now, it's important to understand in this case what the parentheses are doing here. It's identifying what the base of that power is. The entire base is negative 5. Now, anytime we take a base to an exponent 0, except in the case of 0 here, that's going to end up being just 1. Now, compare that, though, to this question, and I'll leave this visible here. Okay. Notice in this case here, what is the base of the power? What is the power in this expression? Well, the answer is a to the 0 is the power, the base is a. So negative 2 is not the base of that power. If I had parentheses around this whole thing, it would be part of the base. But as it stands right now, no, it's not. What that negative 2 is a coefficient of the power. So this is really going to end up being negative 2 multiplied by, well, a to the 0 is simply 1. And so then our result here is simply going to be negative 2. Okay? Now, if that's not 100% clear, let's maybe go back to this one. Let's just throw another question here. If this had been written like this, negative 5 to the 0, maybe here's another case here. What's the power here? Well, the power here is 5 to the 0, not negative 5 to the 0. Okay, not negative 5 to the 0. When you read that like that, when people read this as negative 5 to the 0, you are applying the order of operations incorrectly. When you read this off here, you must deal with the exponent prior to the multiplication by negative 1. Okay, that's just an order of operations issue and people do this wrong. This really should be understood to be negative 1 multiplied by 5 to the 0. Now, you do the exponent first. That's what the order of operations tells us to do. 5 to the 0 is 1, okay? And 1 multiplied by negative 1 is simply negative 1. So that negative survives because it's not part of the base. Anyway, I hope that's clear. You need some clarity on the notation, and really, you need to be applying order of operations correctly. Let's take a look at one more here. Now, in this particular case, the whole purpose of this question here is just so that you understand that it doesn't really matter how complicated that base is. It makes no difference whatsoever. The whole thing here, the base here is this negative 2a cubed b squared, but the exponent is 0, so the whole thing is just going to go to 1.
The following are examples of the negative exponents law.
Right. Now we're going to take a look at a handful of questions here that basically push us to work with negative exponents. Okay. So here, we got 2/3 to the negative 4 here. My advice to you is deal with the negative, like apply the order of operations, but once you're looking at exponents, deal with the negative first. Okay, think of this as like negative 1 multiplied by 4. And you just do them one after another here. Now what that negative does, maybe I should write it like this, this might help here, to the negative 1 to the 4, so they're multiplied together here. You can see this, you can separate that out here. What that negative 1 does is causes a reciprocal in the base. Okay? It causes a reciprocal in the base here. Now, at least that's one way of interpreting it. We're going to see in the next question here that there's another way of thinking about that. Now you're going to apply the 4 to the numerator and denominator, so 3 to the 4 over 2 to the 4. Okay, and when you do that and evaluate that, we'll get 81 over 16. Now let's go over here. Although we can still interpret it like this, you might think of this as m to the negative 1 cubed, m to the negative 2, sorry, negative 1 squared. Okay, that's one way of dealing with this. And then what you could do is you could flip these things around here, and so you would make this, for example, that negative 1 is going to cause, now, maybe in this case, because the base is not a fraction, another way to think about it might be that it moves it to the other part of the rational here. So this is going to move down. This 3 stays with it. Here, this case that moves up, 2 stays with it here. That's one way that you could do this. And then you could make this, this would be the same as, sorry, I'll just do it down here. Now I can deal with the subtraction of the exponents. So m to the 2 minus 3, which ends up being negative 1. And oh, look at that. I got a negative exponent there. That negative exponent's going to force me to the other side of the fraction. So I get that there. Now, that's one way of doing this. Now, I've probably made that a little bit more difficult than it needs to be. Okay. Come back up to this. Notice that we've got 2 powers of m where the bases are the same. I think you'd be smarter in this particular case to simply do this. Make this negative 3 minus negative 2. Just apply, because it's the division here, apply the roulette gives you subtraction here. Now, negative 3 minus negative 2 is going to be negative 1. Taking in mind, being careful when you're dealing with the negatives. And now, as we just said here, that negative is simply going to cause a reciprocal in the base. So instead of being m to the 1, this will be 1 over m to the 1. Okay. Over here, you might want to do the exact same thing. Notice that negative 2 is a coefficient. Please don't include the negative 2 here. Like, if one way that you could do this, for example, would be to move this x cubed down to the denominator. You would think of this as negative 2 times x to the negative 1 cubed all over x squared. And so one thing that you could do immediately is to simply move that x cubed down to the denominator. So you've got like x cubed, x squared down here, and leave the negative 2 up top. Now I've seen, this is a method that a lot of people choose to use here. The mistake is to move the 2 with that. Okay, but the 2 isn't part of the base, it's not part of the power at all, it's a coefficient. And then in the denominator, what you would do here would be, because you're multiplying 2 powers of x together, you would add the exponents, and so this would become x to the 5th. Okay, that is one way of doing it. Now, again, probably not the best way to do that, although you should be aware that that is something that you could do. You'd probably be smarter, though, because you've got division here, to simply apply the rule for division. So this will become negative 3 minus 2. So negative 2 x to the negative 5. Okay, and again, that negative on that x is going to force a reciprocal to happen, but it doesn't apply to the negative 2. The negative 2 stays there in the numerator. And then that x to the 5th simply moves into the denominator. With this last question in this section here, we're going to apply order of operations. We are going to deal with what's inside here first. Now, there's not a lot of simplification that can happen here because these 2 powers have different bases. But it's going to be argued that it's simpler if I have the y to a positive exponent. That y to the negative 3. That negative is going to force it up into the numerator. So this will become x squared y cubed cubed. So now I've dealt with what's inside the parentheses. Now that 3 will distribute to the both those factors inside here. And again, I can do this because it's multiplication. If it was a binomial or larger in there, I couldn't do what I'm about to do here. And so this becomes x to the 2 times 3, y to the 3 times 3, so this becomes x to the 6th, y to the 9th.
The following are examples of the rational exponents law.
All right, now in this section of questions here, this is a little bit of review because we've looked at rational exponents before, but just to go over this ground again here. So I've got 25 to the 1 half. Okay, remember that denominator there forms my root index. So this is the square root of 25. Now, I really encourage you to be very, very clear with your notation here. Okay, math, a huge chunk of mathematics is communication. Okay, it's one thing for you to understand something, but if you cannot communicate to somebody else that you understand it, for all intents and purposes, you don't understand it. Okay, I mean, and that sounds kind of harsher, but really that's the case here. You need to be able to communicate. Notation is very, very important in this process here. That 2, if it's a square root, either you don't write it or you make sure it's clearly within the root symbol there. Okay? If that 2 ends up out front, it's a coefficient. You have miscommunicated. It looks like you don't understand what you're doing. And so now this is the square root of 25, and we know that what that means is, okay, and I don't have to write that square root anymore. We would write that 25 as 5 times 5, and a square root takes two factors and spits out a single factor, a single representative there. So the answer is 5. Okay, now we'll do this a little bit quicker here. So 36 to the 3 halves, my root index is 2. I don't need to write it. And the exponent here, the power there is going to be, the exponent, not the power. The power is the whole thing. The exponent there is going to be 3. Now, I told you before that you're probably smarter to do it like this, to do the exponent here later, apply that after the radical. 36, I would break that down into its prime factors, which will be 2 times 2 times 3 times 3. I can bring out a 2. I can bring out a 3. Okay, because I got a pair of 2s, a pair of 3s. Now, what that's going to do is that's going to give me a 6 outside here. Okay? And 6 cubed is going to be 216. Over here, there's not a whole lot I can do here because I don't know what the base is. So I'm not going to be able to give you a number here. So the best that I can do here is interpret what that rational exponent is giving me. And that is now giving me a cube root. And in this case, I need to write the root index to be clear that is a cube root. The base is going to be a here. And then I would probably put parentheses out there and put a 2 out there. Okay, put that exponent outside. You could go inside. It's typically easier if it's outside. All right, now here, this one. This one's got a lot going on here. We got to be really careful about this one. First of all, let's identify the power and what's going on here. Where's the power? Well, the power is right here. What's the base of the power? This is important. Well, it's just x. It's just, without parentheses here, the base of the power is just x. Negative 3 is a coefficient. Okay? So this really should be written as negative 3 x, okay, to the negative 1/5. Now, let's think of this more like this. Base is x, and this is to the negative 1 to the 1/5. So let's just deal with this in order here. The negative is going to cause a reciprocal to happen. So it's going to take that power, now just the power, not the coefficient, just the power. It's going to move it to the denominator. So this becomes negative 3 over x to the 1/5. And now, because the purpose of this set of questions here is to deal specifically with the rational exponents, what I'm going to do here is I will rewrite this, and I'm not going to be able to do much with it because I don't know what x is, but I can at least rewrite this in the right form and make that the 5th root of x. That's what we're looking for. Okay, and we want to make sure that 5 is written in the correct space here. All right, and this question right here, in contrast to the previous one that we just did here, we're gonna identify the power. What's the power here? Well, the power is 4x cubed to the 1/2. The base in this case is all of that, okay? There is no coefficient. I mean, okay, somebody can argue, well, wait a minute. Yeah, it is. It's going to end up being 2. And I know where you're going with that. But for right now, just looking at the power the way it's written right now, there's no coefficient. The base is 4x cubed. So to write this in radical form here, this is going to be the square root, because it's 1/2, of 4x cubed. Okay, now we should probably simplify that. This is the square root of 2 times 2 times x times x times x. And I'm looking for pairs of factors. So I got a pair of 2s and a pair of x's. So 2x.
And there's still a root x that I couldn't take out.
Okay, that x was left over.
And now finally, this one right here.
Similar sort of question here. I got to look at this and identify what is the power here. Well, the whole thing is the power. The base is x to the 6th y. And so what I'm going to do here is simply write this in radical notation. So this is going to be the cube root of x to the 6th y.
Now, I'm going to be a little bit lazy here. I'm not going to write out 6 x's here. But I do know that I'm looking for triplets. And if I've got 6 of them, I'm going to have 2 groups of 3 x's, which means I can pull out an x squared.
Now, I've still got a cube root here because I've still got something underneath it. That y, there was just a single y, there's not much I can do there.
So that's the answer to this thing in simplified form.
The following are just mixed examples of all of the previous laws.
Okay, now to finish off here, we're going to take a look at a group of questions here where we're not really specifically told what rule to apply, we're just told to simplify this. Now simplifying in this case is really going to mean, for the most part here, basically taking the exponent and making it the smallest possible number that we can, okay? Whether it's positive or negative, we're trying to get it closer and closer to zero here. Now, notice that it says simplify each, leave all the answers with positive exponents. That is not necessarily part of simplifying. That's something we got to state extra to that, okay? So just be aware that that's what's going on here.
So anyway, here we go. So b to the 5th multiplied by b divided by b squared. Now there are some shortcuts we can take here, but because we're just introducing this topic right now, let's focus on the rules here that we gotta apply. First of all, the bar right there implies a set of brackets around the numerator and denominator.
Order of operations tells me to deal with what's in brackets first.
So the first thing I'm gonna do is this multiplication that shows up in the numerator. When I multiply two powers that have the same base, I'm going to add the exponents.
Okay, that's all I'm going to do.
Now this is going to end up being b to the 6th divided by b squared.
Once that's done, division is going to become subtraction, and so this is going to become b to the 4. That's my final answer. Now I did that in several steps.
I'm hoping that you'd be able to do this a little bit quicker, that you would see what's going on here, that you would see, for example, that this is going to be b to the 5 plus 1 minus 2.
Okay, because you're going to do the multiplication first and then you're going to do the subtraction here. You still get the same result here. You can do it a little bit quicker here. The more comfortable you get, everybody, the more comfortable you get with the rules that we are applying here, the faster you're going to get through this. Okay, the more comfortable you are with this, the more happy you're going to be doing something like this. Anyway, let's keep going here.
Same thing, that line implies parentheses, so I'm going to work with the power of the power first. Okay, I still would have worked with that anyway because I'm going to deal with the exponents first. This becomes y to the 7th over y to the 2 times 3, which will be y to the 7 over y to the 6th. And now division is going to become subtraction. And 7 minus 6 is just 1. And if the exponent's 1, I don't need to write it. Over here, first thing we're going to do is deal with what's inside the exponents. Okay, well, there's really no simplification that can occur within the exponents here. I meant brackets. Okay, 2a to the fourth, there's no simplification, there's no simplification there. So order of operations tells me that the next thing I'm going to deal with is the exponents. Because these are, well, this is in particular here, this is just a monomial with two factors here. I'm going to distribute the 3 through, so this will become 2 cubed multiplied by a to the 4 times 3. Now this is all in brackets here. And I'm going to do the same thing over here, and I might as well do it right now, because they are separated by a multiplication sign. So I'm going to deal with exponents across the whole thing. So this will be a to the 3 times 2. So right now I'm going to get 8, a to the 12, multiplied by a to the 6th.
Now I'm multiplying these together, but I'm also multiplying these together. Everything's being multiplied together here. So order doesn't really matter. I can drop the parentheses here.
And when you multiply two powers together with the same base, and by the way, these are the only two that I can actually multiply together. Base stays the same, and I'm simply going to add the exponents together. And so this will become 8 multiplied by a to the 18. Okay. Now, again, I'm going to be really strict with this. The very first thing I'm going to do here is deal with what's inside the parentheses here. Now, I was told to simplify using positive exponents. So now there is a negative exponent here, so I'm going to deal with that first. So that negative exponent is going to push that into the denominator, but just that x, okay?
Because when I look at that power here, the base of that power is just the x. The negative 2 is a coefficient. Okay, unless there were parentheses around that in particular with that negative 1 as an exponent. No, just the x is the base here.
Now, what I'm going to do here, because everything is being multiplied or divided here, that 3 can distribute to each of the exponents. Now, I'm going to treat this as negative 2 cubed. So negative 2 cubed. The whole thing here is going to be the base because that 3 will be distributed to everything. So it'll cover both the negative there and the value. This will be y to the 4 times 3 because I've got a power of a power. And then x cubed. The exponent on the x is 1. Just multiply it through. And so negative 2 cubed is going to be negative 8. This will be y to the 12 over x cubed. Whoops, there you go. Okay. Here we go. Now, I'm going to multiply these together, but the first thing I'm going to do is look at what's inside the parentheses here. There's really no simplification I can do, other than the fact that I was told initially that I want to write these with positive exponents. So I'm going to deal with this one first here. So this will be negative 3m squared n, negative 4m to the 4th over n squared. All that happens is that negative moves it to the other side here. The 2 goes with it. Okay, it just moves to the other side of that rational factor. Now, I'm going to multiply. Now, bear in mind, though, that n squared here is in the denominator, and this n right here is in the numerator. Now, you got to be careful when you multiply fractions together. This tends to be a point where I'm seeing a lot more people make mistakes here. This does not distribute to both the numerator and denominator. You simply multiply numerators together, multiply the denominators together. Okay, please make sure you're doing that correctly. Negative 3 multiplied by negative 4. I can multiply the coefficients together. They're both numbers. I see what they are. Negative 3 times negative 4 is positive 12. M squared multiplied by m to the 4th. I'm going to add the exponents together. N, well, there isn't an n in the numerator, so I'm just going to leave it there. It's like n multiplied by 1. Just like down here in the denominator, that's going to be 1 multiplied by n squared. Okay, so now this will be 12, m to the 6th, I should say. Now, n over n squared, I can do this a couple of different ways. I can treat this as an exponent of 1 and then subtract the 2 there. So this is going to end up being 12, m to the 6th, n to the negative 1. And I'm running out of room, so I'll go sideways here. So this will be 12m to the 6th all over n. Now that is not the only way to see that, okay? But if you're just getting comfortable with these ideas of negative exponents, it might help to break it down like this, okay? Our next one. Okay, remember that division symbol there puts brackets around the numerator and the denominator. So the very first thing I'm going to do is deal with what's in the numerator here. So x to the fifth multiplied by x to the negative 1 will be x to the fifth plus negative 1 over negative 2x to the negative 3. So we're going to get x to the 4 over negative 2x to the negative 3.
Oops, sorry.
And now this is going to become, because I'm dividing powers of x there with the same base, I'm going to subtract the exponents. Notice that negative 2 isn't participating in any of this. It's just going to stay there. So this will become x to the 4 minus negative 3 all over negative 2. It just stays there. And again, I'm running out of room, so I'm going to have to go sideways here. So this will be x to the 7 over negative 2. And I can put that negative in front. In fact, it looks a little better to have the negative moved up into the numerator. When you've got a single factor of negative 1 in a fraction, yeah, you can move that kind of wherever you want. But it looks better in the numerator. Oops. Okay, next. Once again, I'm going to be pretty strict with the order of operations. So the very first thing I'm going to do is focus on what's inside the brackets. Now, bearing in mind that division statement there splits this up into parentheses there, but there's nothing that I can simplify in the numerator, there's nothing I can simplify in the denominator. So that's as good as it's going to get. So the next thing I'm going to do is deal with this division here. And so now, the 5 and the 4, I really can't do anything with to simplify that, so I'm just going to leave that. But this is going to become m to the 1 minus 2, okay, because division becomes subtraction. Just like, oops, I haven't given myself enough room there. Just like this will become n cubed minus 1, or to the third minus 1, all squared. And so this will become 5m to the negative 1, m, whoops, why did that, weird, n squared all over 4 squared. And then that m to the negative 1 is going to drop into the denominator, so 5n squared over 4m squared. Now, everything here is going to get squared. The numerator is going to get squared both terms. The denominator is going to get squared both terms. So this is going to become 5 squared, n squared squared, so I'm going to multiply the two together, that's a power of a power, over 4 squared m squared. And so we'll get 25 n to the 4th over 16m squared. And again, you very likely could have gotten there faster than what I'm doing here. The more comfortable you get with this, the quicker this process is going to get, because you're going to see where you can, it's not necessarily skipping steps. I don't want you to think that I'm skipping steps, because I'm not, I wouldn't have been skipping steps. I can get here really quickly, not because I'm skipping steps, but because the more comfortable you get with this, the more steps you can do at once. You don't have to break them down into individual steps written out here. You can bunch them up here. That's really what we want to get you to here. Okay, following order of operations, remember that line puts a set of parentheses there, so this is going to become m cubed n to the negative 2 all over. Okay, well, first thing I'm going to do here is I would try to simplify what's inside these brackets here, but there's really nothing to simplify. So the very first thing I gotta do then down here is deal with the exponent. So this is going to become 3 squared m squared. Now, here's a spot where I'm just going to, instead of writing this out, I'm just gonna do this. Because this is gonna be n to the 4th squared, this will be n to the 8th. And now I've still got m to the 5th n squared over here. So m cubed n to the negative 2. This is going to become 9. Now, and then again, I'm going to try to speed this up a little bit here. Instead of writing this out, I'm just going to do it. This is going to be m squared multiplied by m to the 5th. I just need to multiply those together here. I wanted to write that out. It's so odd. I'm just going to do it here. 2 plus 5 is going to be 7. Just like n to the 8th, n squared is going to be n to the 10. Now, that 9 is just going to stay down there in the denominator, but for the time being, and I will do this kind of one step at a time here, sort of. I'm going to speed this up a little bit more than what I've been doing here. I've got m cubed now over m to the 7th. In the numerator, that's going to be m to the 3 minus 7. So that's going to be m to the negative 4. Here, this will be n to the negative 2 divided by n to the 10th. Is going to be, in the numerator, will be n to the negative 2 minus 10, or n to the negative 12. And the very last thing I'm going to do, because the question was asking me to write these things with positive exponents, I'm going to move these guys into the denominator. So now, I've seen people do this where they do this incorrectly. They think they're moving into the denominator, and yet they don't write a fraction. And if you don't write a fraction, the assumption is that what you've done is put it in the numerator. So if everything moves out down to the denominator, it's going to leave me with a 1 in the numerator, 9m to the 4th, n to the 12th. Okay, and finally, here, the negative 3. Now, what I would try to do here first is simplify what's inside, but there's nothing to simplify. The 2 and the 3, that's 2/3. That's about as simple as that fraction's going to get. There's no shared factors there. X squared and y, as far as we can tell, there's nothing common about those two. Okay, got to leave those separate here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to treat this as to the power of negative 1 times 3. So I'm going to deal with the negative 1 first, which is going to cause a reciprocal. Cubed. Now, I see a negative that's in here, and I'm cubing a negative, so I already know that that negative is going to stay. Now, I'm just going to start to do these things really quickly here. So this is going to become 3 cubed, because they're multiplied together. They're not added or subtracted here. So 3 cubed is 27. Y cubed is just that, y cubed. I already know the negative is going to pop out, because a negative cubed is going to stay negative, but 2 cubed is going to be 8. And now here's the one that we need to make sure that we get right here. X squared cubed, if I've got a power of a power, you simply multiply the exponents and you get x to the 6th. And so there you go. So like I was saying, the more comfortable you get with this, the more steps you can do simultaneously is going to be the best way to write that. I should say that.